course of teaching about church is based for approximately 2,000 years on the teaching of the Holy Apostles. That is why it is called the Apostolic Church. The Holy Apostles were the first disciples of Christ. They received teaching from him for 3 years by hearing Christ, by seeing Christ's miracles, and helping their distressed fellow human beings. Thus, they themselves became carriers of the revelation of God and apostles of the evangelical message. That is, the message of salvation through Christ. The Holy Apostles were not well-known scholars, nor were they distinguished political men, neither were they wealthy people, but they were also sinners. The Holy Apostles were simple, honest people, full of love for their distressed human beings. Above all, however, an outstanding they were pious people. They were guileless, innocent people. Would not think of malice against anyone. They were God's people. Furthermore, most of Christ's disciples had received their leadership from that great prophetic leader, John the Baptist, who with his ascetic life and his sermon of repentance
and there was a lot of people who relied on the same of the gospel.
people everywhere who wait to hear the word of God. But even so, we are unable to harvest it because we are living in enlightened people who are ready to leave everything, to leave their comfortable way of life, to become apostles for humanity to be saved. However, if this is difficult to achieve, just as it was in Christ's time, let it take some people to stop fighting against the contemporary apostles of our time who have been called by God to evangelism for humanity. These people do not merely fight against those honest words of the gospel, but against the word of God for the evangelism of the world. Our blessed patriarch, Theophilus, our metropolitans, our bishops, our worthy clergy, the cooperation of our pioneering lay people, support in many ways, in many places, spiritually and materially, the work of our church. We continue our historical 2,000-year course, heading towards the third millennium. We try to follow the example of the Holy Apostles, transferring the evangelical message of salvation to all races of the earth by participating with our prayers and works in the social problems of our communities. The apostolic identification of our church is preserved when we follow the daily examples